Good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. I hope you can hear me. Honnan tudom, hogy ők hallanak engem is egyáltalán? Jó, akkor vagy akkor a... Oké. Good afternoon again. I apologize for this slight complication with the technical setup. No, I hope you can hear me well. Thank you for the feedbacks in the chat. Please warn me if something would go technically wrong. My name is András Szűcs. I serve as Secretary General of EDEN, the European Distance and E-Learning Network. And well, one of the reasons of the slight delay was also that just in the last hour before starting this webinar, we had a very important and useful phone conference with the ICDE, the World Organization for Open and Distance Education, about the involvement of the continental or regional associations like Europe, Asia, Africa, Australia, etc. And well, just to share you the pleasure of having a very constructive and good meeting, which will help the cooperation and synergies between the large organizations in different continents. I was invited to speak about initiative, about a project which is supported by the European Commission, and the aim of this project is in the higher education sector to support the strategy development, the work of the high level decision makers in introducing the latest forms of digital and online instruction at the universities, and to help to develop comprehensively the strategies for the institutional realization. The name of the project is the Transform. It is quite usual to have such an acronym for this European Union initiatives. But it says that digital resources as a new strategic factor for innovation and modernization in higher education. You always have to be pretty creative in inventing such acronyms, because it may contribute to the to receiving the support from the Commission if it is attractive and positive enough. The European Commission has different support schemes in the field of education. In these years, this is the what is called Erasmus Plus. This is one of the several educational and learning innovation and modernization action lines. Here, at the first few slides, we summarize what is this project for. The target group are leaders of the European universities, really the high-level senior management, if you wish, and the aim is to understand better the role of what here is called e-education for developing the strategies and the modernization and transformation of the institutions using the latest generation of digital resources, including open educational resources and massive online courses. Shortly about technical detail, like the composition of this partnership. We have a very strong coordinating institution in France, Fondation Maison des Sciences de l'Homme, University of Lorraine, a company from the UK, Zero Consulting, which has been pretty successful in providing contribution and impact at the European Union programs. One of the leading online European universities, Open Universities, Universidad Oberta de Catalunya in Barcelona, then the Polytechnic of Milano, four organizations, and the Budapest University of Technology and Economics. We have an international advisory board, which consists of prestigious scholarly people and supports by its yearly meetings, supervising the progress of the project to the achievements. what does the project do? In the last, in the first 2 years, a sort of research about the business models in this open education and digital education field, collecting case studies and university strategy supporting recommendations. It is quite a challenge to organize what we call leadership schools for university governance. The first one will take place next week in Barcelona, and then next year in Paris. And among the project tasks and aims is also the development of an own D-Transform MOOC, which should be ready next year. here is a short description about the leadership school, for which very intensive preparations already take place next week, again at the Universidad de Oberta de Catalunya in Barcelona. As I mentioned, the target audience identification for this leadership school is pretty ambitious, targeting rectors, vice rectors, deans, and institutional director level people. It's particularly ambitious because this leadership school will last 5 days next week, and this is really exceptional to be able to attract these kind of peoples, and several or many of them. We have already a few dozens registered to this event to be far from their universities and offices, but maybe also because Barcelona in the middle of November is not a very bad place. Anyway, so we look forward, as I see the progress of preparations, well-populated leadership school with a rich program. We were able to attract really high-level speakers, probably one of the reasons of the success of recruitment of the university leaders. And of course, these several days spent together in a conference hotel in Barcelona gives opportunity for networking, sharing experience, to have a better understanding about the policies, but also for the actual work of the university seniors to receive some new knowledge and new skills in strategy and the actually more and more important business model issues. this is a list of key topics extracted from the conference or leadership school workshop, how should we call it, program, understanding the new generation of learners, the role of digital libraries, then something which is definitely very much worth of discussing without interruption, how can the higher education institutions adapt positive approach towards learning innovation, online solutions, and the respective institutional organizational and operational changes. One of the issues high on the agenda is in this year's is the online assessment, and with the increasing capacity and performance of the digital devices, this online assessment solutions, in particular the authentication part, is actually what I have seen really impressively developing, and presenting such solutions of appropriate credibility to the university leaders can help a lot to convince the decision makers to rely to a larger extent on the digital solutions in higher education. Then again, there is a lot of information, communication, news, gossips and whatever about MOOCs, what they may mean, is this a kind of hype, something fashionable, or something substantially really contributing to the higher education institutions operations? Well, then lessons to be learned, a lot of good case studies, and then how to apply and introduce in the own institution this potential developments, the change management techniques. A few words about the MOOC, which the project consortium is expected to develop. This is to support the previously mentioned strategic and conceptual ideas. still, we cannot stop pushing the awareness raising about the online and digital learning on its potentials, what they are good for, what they are not good for, how they can have an impact on the institutions and even on larger scale on the educational systems and all this on executive senior level at the universities. In the meantime, with the compulsory, I can say, networking element. Well, I have more or less explained in the previous slides what the expected outcomes should be. To get closer to a critical mass on the university senior leadership level, to the better understanding and willingness to rely more and introduce and apply the latest more and more credible and consolidated solutions of the online learning at the universities. Part of the project activities has been a sort of research, a survey, including Spain, France, Italy, and the UK as examples, including the context of the national developments to the EU policies. Well, a few words about the EU policies in this field. Well, as the title of the slide also says, it is often justifiable to use a critical voice regarding how the EU policies are developed, how relevant they are, and what is the grade of success in their promoting change. Let's identify three phases of this digital learning EU support the Lisbon strategy according, this is a quotation from the wording of the respective part of this EU strategic document. The key words have been principally quality, access, and cooperation. As next phase, in the mid-time of the Lisbon strategy implementation, the further integration of the ICT enhanced solutions was on the agenda, and some adjustments to the sectorial programs as written here was implemented. In the EU 2020 program from 2010 to 2020, the program, which or the educational sub-program, so to say, was the opening up education scheme, which already included the open educational resources and MOOCs issues. Actually, in particular, no, after the halftime of the EU 2020 strategy, when we have more and more clearly witnessed an economic crisis in Europe, certainly, and therefore the policy aims of the European Commission, so actually I would say the vocabulary of the Commission regarding how the world of learning, the education and training priorities and conceptual approaches should be shaped. This became quite, how should I say, pragmatic. So the catchwords or the keywords also in the Commission programs became employability, economic growth, and the respective contribution of the educational institutions to these changes and developments. This opening up education scheme, well, the timing was not quite ideal. You see, it was in 2013, practically before the European Parliament elections and the new European Commission set up, which is, as always, accompanied by quite some changes in the senior leadership of the Directorate Generals, the concepts of implementation, etc. So this is not a very strong document, and another initiative earlier this year, the new skills agenda. Again, this is about skills, skills supporting employability and economic growth is the next step. So I wouldn't say that there is a strong policy background, no, for learning innovation, digital learning development in Brussels. Yes, this is some quotation about critical voices regarding the European Commission programs implementation, which again is suggesting a pragmatic and, how should I say, more down-to-earth approach, focusing on broadband networking access issues, less than about the methodological digital learning, digital pedagogy issues. And well, I think with good reasons, there are some implementation and management problems also raised. Well, I I just would like to show this slide about the keywords of the EU 2020 program main outlines. I guess this is not very new for most of you. Just I am recalling what has earlier been mentioned about the necessity of developing educational offer competencies coming from the economy, the strong voice of the corporate stakeholders. In the meantime, criticizing the performance and efficiency of the university education, the dropout rate, and trying to push the higher education to play a, let's say, more useful role in the European agenda. Just a few words about the findings in these case studies in the countries investigated in digital policies. Well, perhaps it is not very surprising to see that in France the overwhelming power of the state and government, the centralized movements and actions are dominant. In the meantime, my impression has been that there is a correct resourcing mostly for the implementation of digital policies in the institutions, not mainly at the universities, but in many cases there is a sort of either regional or structural cooperation among the development agencies, educational institutions, research, and including corporations. Yes, the Italians per nature are often enjoying a relative autonomy. In Spain, probably also due to the well, not very strong shape of the economy and the lack of governmental resources, this what was described as non-state trio of actors, these three mega companies, is characterizing the scene. In the UK, I find this as a very appropriate wording. It is not my wording, that the discontinuity in the public policies. I would add that in the meantime, quite a pragmatic and down-to-earth approach is characterizing the actions. We should add in the meantime that the role of the open distance digital online learning solutions has really pretty high professional and implementation culture in the UK, quite higher than in many other parts of Europe. Let's say the only region where this professional culture for open and innovative learning is higher is the Scandinavic region, of course. So in a few words, just this introduction, you will remember these initiatives, the UK University and University for Industry, which were announced and large impact expected, but finally closer to failure than a success. In the introduction of this webinar, we have offered also some insight in the business models of the open education models. Professor Beksic, who is now a senior researcher at the Ciro Consulting, one of the project partners, has assembled mostly the following sites. So I am using this as a quotation from him as a sort of project deliverable. The open educational resources are present in all the countries of the European Union and are to some extent followed up or acknowledged by the government as well. Central financing is an exception with France or Slovenia. In the meantime, it has to be acknowledged that whilst the open educational resources play an important role in the informal, non-formal learning sectors, but in higher education, they represent only a small part of the student portfolio, at least as it is put in the curricula. For MOOCs, again, it's understandable that it is present everywhere, however, with a relatively low level of of activity. Well, of course, the scenario is changing every month or semester. Only in France we can report about a sort of national policy for the MOOCs. And the picture is quite diverse when we have a look at the impact of MOOCs on the university strategies and in particular on their practical implementation. I am quoting again Professor Beksic, listing here the MOOC business models, one which we can call as freemium, this is then well, which is based on the free access. Then this indirect financing sort of implementation called loss leader, where the invested efforts are recovered either by a measurable impact on the popularity or recruitment power of the institution, or as in the civic role model, when not directly through the institution's economic results, but through their social mission, is this MOOC activity acknowledged. Finally, this hovering model is again a sort of indirect approach, of course, to the MOOC investment recovery. What about this linked dimensions of the MOOCs developments, the research dimension is evident. The MOOCs have contributed substantially to the acknowledged contribution and presence of the digital solutions in the higher education sector, and this was quite a sort of breakthrough for the learning innovation solutions at the universities, and it is opening quite some opportunities to research in areas with the presence of a large-scale, measurable, researchable activity in the institutions. The improving and rapidly developing of capacities and performance of the later generation digital devices and the speed and the capacity of the networking helps also in what is here called a third party model. This is clearly a business issue through the online presence and the step by step and practically byte by byte measurable activities of the students in the digital systems of the institutions is offering the opportunity to the sophisticated learning analytics solutions, which may of course have a business dimension regarding their behaviors and student data. And as long the MOOC models are not only focusing on the higher education part, but extended to the vocational and professional training, professional further education and retraining, then of course the business feasibility is further increasing. Thank you so much. This is the end of our presentation, and Well, I am not sure if I was properly instructed regarding whether it is expected to have some questions or comments to the presentation. I may need some advice from my colleagues, but in any case, we have a few more minutes for an eventual such communication. Yes, I am advised to invite questions. I think what the technology allows is principally to do it in the chat box. If there is any, I will try to do my best to respond. Okay, if this is not the case, then I thank you very much for your attention, and I would like to close then this webinar. No, let me mention that this is one of the activities of Eden for learning innovation, ICT enhanced learning development. I invite you to contact the secretariat or myself. You can easily find the possibilities on the Eden web. Thank you very much indeed.